All the cat hair just comes out of your face.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
So today's video, we wanted to do just like an update on where we are and instead of an unboxing, which we have one. We did receive a gift this week, but we're going to give that that video will probably come out in a couple of days. Today, we just want to talk about the gender of the baby. And as you all know, we're not finding out what the sex is of the baby. And regardless of what this video thinks, don't send us messages thinking that we know.
Yeah, we don't know. We don't find out. It's a mystery.
Mm-hmm. We have not found out.
Nope.
But we wanted to do some speculating on what we think.
Yeah.
Yes. Based on some things that are like mystical things that I don't know anything about. All I know is some buzzwords.
Like old wives' tales, basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know some buzzwords that I can get her talking about what it could be. But other than that, I don't know how this magic mystery box of figuring out what gender the baby is.
How it works.
So I guess we start with how many weeks are you?
27 weeks.
27 weeks. So you're officially...
I'm officially in my third trimester now.
Okay.
So the countdown is on.
So we're like under 100 days.
It's like 90... No, sorry, 89 days or something like that today.
89 days. So... Yeah. It's coming,
yeah.
No matter what you...
No matter what I think or if I change my mind or not, mm-hmm. It's still coming.
So when was your last doctor's appointment?
It was a week ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and that's where one of these wives' tales are in. It's like, it's mm-hmm. what the heart rate of the baby is.
Yes.
If it's... So what is
so
that?
So the wives' tale is supposed to be that if it's under 140 beats per minute, it's a boy. And if it's above 140 beats per minute, it's a girl.
Okay.
And this baby has consistently been 150 to 155.
Okay, so I wasn't paying attention. Over 140 is girl?
Girl.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Under 140 is a boy.
Gotcha.
And if that's the case, that holds true for both our other kids, too.
Okay.
Like, Demetrius was always on the lower end, and Isabel was always up higher.
Okay. So right now, my fear is that we have another girl.
Your fear.
Yeah. I can't, like, stress... emotional handle having another girl.
That's because you're going to have a teenage girl.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, considering that her 12th birthday is this week. And they just had a birthday party where they played Truth or Dare.
With boys there.
I cannot handle, like, having another girl.
Yeah, exactly.
So but you'll be okay.
Yeah.
You'll be okay.
So that one leans toward, if you believe those sayings, that one leads toward a girl.
Okay. So then, but everything was fine at the appointment.
Everything right. was great, yeah. Mm-hmm. The baby measures a little bigger than it's supposed to be, but it's pretty much measured bigger the whole time, so mm-hmm. that's not really. And everything's great, heart rate's great, you know, my blood pressure's, like, wonderful, everything's good, so.
So how are you feeling?
I feel good. I'm tired all the time, but other than that, not sleeping very well, but that's between being pregnant and having a kitten, so.
Yeah. So, that's the next wives' tale, how are you carrying then?
Yeah, the next,
so what is that?
The next wives' tale is supposed to be, and this one is opposite. Well, for us, it worked out for our kids the way it was supposed to. If you carry really high up, you're supposed to be carrying a girl. Isabel was like super high up. Like,
mm-hmm. It's like
I was
shelf.
Up here. Yeah,
had, like,
yeah, exactly.
Tea on your belly.
Yeah, I could eat things off my belly. Then with Demetrius, I was carrying like super low. It was like he would...
Like in a wheelbarrow.
Yeah. It was like he could just fall out any day. But so, and this baby, I'm carrying it super low.
So, let me get this straight. We have a baby with a heartbeat above 140, which yep. means girl.
Yeah.
But you're carrying really low, which means boy.
And we've already had that. So they contradict themselves because they both.
So we've had both, and both have been true.
Yeah. So, how does this work? Yeah.
Okay. And then the same thing with those wives' tales and like how you're feeling. One of them is. Foods you crave,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, foods you crave is, it's supposed to be if you crave, like, salty or savory items, you know, which would be nachos and stuff like that, you know, those things, that would be for a boy.
Okay.
But if you crave sugary or, like, sweets and citrus, that would be a girl. And I have spent my entire pregnancy drinking chocolate milk and pink lemonade.
Uh-huh.
And, I mean, we went to IKEA yesterday, and they got french fries, and I got a slice of cake.
We go to IKEA, and all we're there for is to buy a crib and stuff like that, which will be a different video at a, later time, because Melissa's mom was nice enough to send us a check, and we went to IKEA and got the stuff that we need, basically, for the, not everything, but most stuff we need for the crib. Mm-hmm. We have, like, the starter for the crib.
Yeah.
And so we go into IKEA, and the first thing we do is, obviously, when you come in, you can smell, like, the meatballs and everything like that when you come in.
We'll get a snack.
We should get a snack. Me and the kids got french fries.
That was the plan. I was supposed to go through the line and get french fries.
Uh-huh. And so then what did you end up getting?
3-layer chocolate cake. And I didn't eat any of the french fries. But.
So, sweet seems to be the
trend. So that would indicate a girl.
Uh-huh. But with our other kids, that's like, we didn't really fit that.
Because I wanted nachos through both pregnancies, and I ate, like, there was no correlation
with
that.
Isabel, do you think the nachos thing wasn't what you were actually craving, but because we lived within walking distance of 7-Eleven?
True, maybe. No, I was craving nachos, yeah. And breakfast food. Well, that's both of them. So I haven't got that yet, but both of my other pregnancies, it was breakfast sandwiches. Like
how many egg croissants did you get with Burger King?
With Demetrius, way too many. My doctor's office was far away, and we would have morning appointments, and me and Isabel would go through the drive-thru a lot.
So right now, we are beats 100, above 140 girl, carrying low boy, and sweet foods
girl.
So 2-1 in favor of girl right now. So the last one is
the Chinese gender calendar, which has been exactly spot on for both our other kids. Off of your age that you conceive the baby and the month you conceive the baby. And if I go by that, then it says a girl with both the kids, with both other our other children. It was exactly right.
So we're 3-1, girl to boy. Okay, so let's just play like imaginary, you know, like imagination land. What do you think it is?
Imagination land, like I have any really idea. Like I have no clue. I think what I've thought from the very beginning of this pregnancy is that it's a girl. But that is just because I think, I don't know, because our oldest is a girl. So I'm just thinking like... Girl, boy, girl. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know why. But everybody I talk to says the same thing, which makes me think it's probably a boy. Because everybody who, like, people I don't even really know that well, I'll tell them, like, oh, they say me that I'm pregnant. I go, oh, I think you're having a girl. It's like, okay, thanks for the information. I don't know where that came from.
Well, we've already talked about what my fear is. And it, pretty much, whenever I have that feeling, it's true. So I'm pretty sure it's a girl. To torment me and make me stress out about boys and parties and dating and weddings that I gotta pay for and stuff like that. Yeah. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure that's what it's gonna be. It's gonna be a girl.
I mean, it could be either way. Either way. Either way, we'll be happy. So, you know, it's just, you're gonna be
a wreck. Yeah. Stressful wreck.
Pretty much.
So that's what we got. We think it sounds like it's going to be a girl. We think it's going to be a girl, but we have no idea.
We have no idea, and we won't know until it's born. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're not going to find out.
And for the record, we don't give out. I know some people have asked me about names and stuff. We don't give out names.
We do not talk about names. Nope. And that's not because of because we're not finding out the gender or something like that. We do not talk about names.
No, we just don't. No.
So those are secrets until the baby is born.
Yeah, we have names. I mean, if you want to know our process, we come up with names. He comes up with boy names. I come up with girl names. We go to the hospital with those names. Then when the baby comes out, we look at the baby and go, you look like this name. And that's how we picked both the other kids. We just don't do name things.
So, and Melissa's fully prepared with names. So you could bug her with finding out what the names are.
You can't.
I haven't even thought of it yet.
I'd never give it up. So you can bug me all you want. You'll never get it out of me. And he doesn't even, I even got a book at the library for baby names trying to nudge him, but that doesn't work. So
No, I just think of jumbled names with mixed up letters.
Great.
It'll come to me in a dream at some point in time. So that's all we got for today. Keep an eye out in the next couple days to see an unboxing video. We got a package from Target. That we need to open up, And it's a secret.
Mm-hmm. We don't know.
We don't know who bought it for us.
Or what it is.
And we'll have another video showing all the stuff that we got at IKEA for the crib. That may be later on when we put it all together and set the room up. We'll do like a little talk about what the, where the room is.
And we also have, well, I will be having my ultrasound, like the last ultrasound I'll probably get this pregnancy, on October 1st. So we will have pictures for that coming on that day.
So if you're interested, I might Periscope that live. So if you're interested in watching, get me a send me a message on Twitter, or send Melissa a message on Twitter or Facebook, or leave a comment on our website if you're interested in watching that. And if you are, I can set up a Periscope. That way you can watch it live. And we'll see you in a couple of days.
All right. Bye, guys.